Hey folks, welcome to the Physics Labs. This week we're going to be taking a look at the parallel plate capacitor, a really, really basic system, but it's going to let us explore a whole bunch of different physical concepts in great detail. Now, a couple things that we're going to need to care about here. This week we're going to be using our power supplies and making a couple of very accurate measurements. So we got two warnings for you. One is you need to be very careful when you're working with the power supplies because we're going to be operating at the order of 5 kilovolts or such. Very, very high voltage means you need to be extremely careful. Again, my suggestion as always with high voltage power supplies, leave one hand in the pocket so that way you don't accidentally close a circuit between yourself and maybe the casing. The other thing that you're going to need to worry about too is that we're going to do a lot of uncertainty propagation and analysis in this lab. So make sure you review that section at the beginning of the lab manual to really get down this material. Should be a lot of fairly basic multiplication and division, but it's always good to review these things. Now, what we're going to be doing is using the power supply set to a fairly high voltage to charge up our parallel plate capacitors. And we're going to do that using this switch, which I can complete the connections with here. And the idea is that when this switch is flipped all the way over, connected to our power supply, we're going to be charging up the capacitor to that voltage. And then when I flip the switch over here, I'm going to discharge the capacitor into the coulomb meter. Now the coulomb meter itself will measure how much current flows through it. It'll integrate that current and figure out exactly how much charge has been discharged. Now, you might notice that the number is climbing, and so what you'll need to do is occasionally push that button in the very center to zero this thing out. But what you'll want to do is, let me turn on my power supply, get it to about 5,000 volts, charge up the parallel plate capacitor, discharge into the coulomb meter, and read off the reading that we have here. You're going to do this several times in succession. Make sure that you can get nice repeatable results because we're going to be analyzing this charge that we got on the capacitor and the voltage that we've applied in order to calculate what is the capacitance of this capacitor. Once we're done with that though, we are absolutely done with the power supply. Make sure you turn it all the way down, all the way off. Unplug all the wires. We can turn the coulomb meter back off too. And we're going to take a look at a capacitance meter, connecting this directly up to our capacitor like so. And that will let us measure its capacitance directly. This does the same thing. It applies a voltage, measures the current, calculates capacitance out. But what we can do with this is explore some other things. We can explore stray capacitance from the wires and whatnot that we have attached there. We can also vary the capacitance by changing the distance between the plates or adding in a dielectric. This plastic in the way has a certain dielectric constant. Changes the capacitance of the capacitor, and by making a measurement of the capacitance with and without, we can calculate this thing's dielectric constant. Or we've also got an activity that uses aluminum plates connected across your lab manual. And if you have several pages thrown in there, we have a capacitor with a dielectric inside of it. So this week in lab, lots of really fun things. Again, be really careful with the high voltage power supply. We want you to be safe here. Make sure your TA checks your circuits to make sure everything is wired up correctly and that we don't accidentally burn out the coulomb meter. And have a fun time. See you next week.